in front, stay right where you are. So this guy's name is Pogo. Now, Pogo here could be one of two different animals. Oh yeah, if he goes wee-wee like that, don't worry, he does that all the time. Animals like this guy, they're not like people. They don't like go to, they don't go potty once or twice a day. They like to go a little bit all day long. So not a great pet. Now, this guy could either be a wallaby or it could be a kangaroo, right? They look almost the same. So let's see here. Do you think it's a wallaby? Raise your hand. Okay, and raise your hand if you think it's a kangaroo. Okay. Wait, now raise your hand if you raise your hand both times. I saw a couple of those guys. This is actually a wallaby. But don't worry if you guessed kangaroo. Because, did you see, as soon as he heard that high-pitched noise, he's like, on high alert. He's actually a wallaby because this guy's full grown. He's actually about 2.5 years old, but he won't get any bigger than this. He's about 2.5, 3 feet tall. Kangaroos can get to be about 6 feet tall. I can't carry around a full-grown kangaroo, so these guys are kind of like a fun-sized kangaroo. Okay. Now, kangaroos and wallabies, we all know that they hop, right? These legs right there, are you eating my rug? What are you doing?
He's sniffing your rug.
These legs are so unbelievably strong, and she can kick very hard. Now, wallabies like this actually don't know how to walk. They cannot physically put one foot in front of the other. The only way that they can get around is by hopping, and they are darn good at it. If I were to let Pogo here go right now, So guys, if I did let Pogo go right now and he were to get a hopping start, he could start, let's see here, right, oh, okay, stay. He could start right by you and hop over you, and you, and he would land on you. That's about 15 feet, so that's a seriously big hop. They can hop about 30 miles an hour, too. So that means they have some very strong legs. Also, you are so handsome. I know. Now, okay, you want to turn around, though? I'm doing a show here. Oh, yeah, take the sweet potato. Come on, don't be scared. All right. So guys, also, something else special about them is this tail right here. This tail is pure muscle. It's really strong. It doesn't hurt him at all when I hold on to it. Feels to him like if I gave you a handshake. That's probably about it. Now, they use it to protect themselves. Like I said, these guys can kick. Well, if another animal was coming up behind this guy or in front of this guy, what he could do... Oh, no, he's gonna eat the rug instead, of course. He can actually lean back on that really strong tail, and that will support his whole weight so that he can free up his legs to kick. Keep your hands in. Good job, buddy. Okay. Let's see if he wants another treat. Let's see. Stay right here. He is actually about 2.5 years old. What are you doing? I know, it's okay. Oh, yes, that's the bag. See these ears? They're like little satellites. He has a lot of control over his ears. No, it's nice in there. Okay, we'll give him some other options. Now guys, like I said, they can kick really hard. You might not think that kicking with your feet is a really good like defense or secret weapon to have if like a big animal is attacking you. But I have to tell you that they can kick really, really hard. And I found that out the hard way because one time I made a little mistake. I was cleaning another one of our wallabies' cage and I actually stepped on the very tip of its tail. It did not like that very much. It just turned around, leaned back on its tail and kicked me right in the tummy. Hard as it could, and it was, it was powerful, oh my gosh. So really, it's actually a pretty good defense or secret weapon for them to have. Now, guys, I want to ask you this. What is the thing? Oh, it's peeing. It tingles. Animals do it. You cannot tell animals when to go pot, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Well, you can tell them, but they don't listen. All right. Now, guys, what do wallabies, girl wallabies, have on their bellies?
Pouches.
Pouches, exactly. They have a pouch. You want to see over here?
Does he have a pouch?
Okay. They have a pouch on their bellies. Now, it's just like if you had a really big belly button that you could like open up and stuff all your toys and stuff in there. That's what they have on their bellies. But they don't keep toys in there. They keep their babies in there, right? Now, okay, you want to take a little break? Hold on. Take a break and then he'll come back out. Okay. Alright, now actually, maybe I'll leave him in here for a second. He got a little excited. So I'll see, he might want to eat one of his favorite snacks now that he's in his happy place. Okay. Now guys, here's what happens, alright? Baby wallabies have to live in mama's pouch for 6. Hold up. Wait, watch. Well, maybe he'll pick it up. He's really cute when he eats it. So guys, the baby wallabies have to live in the pouch for 6 months. It's the only way that the baby can grow up properly. Now, we have another wallaby named Matilda back at the farm, and my boss actually raised her from a little baby. When she was born, she was that big. They're born about the size of a little peanut. And my boss had to raise her, but unfortunately my boss, Travis, does not have a pouch on his belly to keep a baby wallaby. So for 6 months, my boss had to carry around a woman's pocketbook with a baby wallaby inside everywhere he went for that 6 months. Now guys, when real mother wallabies have their baby, sometimes kids ask me this, they're like, what does the baby do when the baby has to go potty for that 6 months? Do you think the baby wallaby goes potty in mama's pouch for 6 months?
Yeah.
That would be really gross. Actually, it doesn't work that way. Here's what happens. The mama wallaby is the one that decides when the baby goes to the bathroom. Baby wallabies cannot go on their own. And so this is what the mama has to do every day to make the baby go to the bathroom. Mama has to reach into the pouch, take the baby out, hold baby out here, and lick the baby's tushy. She does that, and that makes the baby go potty outside the pouch, and then the mama puts the baby back in. So it sounds really gross, but if you think about it, it's a great idea. It keeps mama's pouch clean for that 6 months. So this is where sometimes the gears are turning in some of the adults, maybe. I also just told you that my boss, Travis, had to raise our other wallaby for that 6 months, so what do you think my boss had to do? Well, okay, no, my boss Travis did not lick Matilda's tushy. Does anybody want a job? Wallaby butt licker? You don't want that job. I love it. The hands stay up though. It's crazy. Okay, so no, nobody licked Matilda's tushy to make her go potty. That would be disgusting. But what my boss did have to do, every day he would take Matilda in the pocketbook into the bathroom, hold her over the toilet, and rub her tushy with a damp paper towel. And that would make her go potty in the toilet, and then he would put her back in the pocket. So guys, that is what you do if you have to raise wallabies. They require a lot of love, put it that way. All right, well, I'll leave him open like this so you guys can see. Are there any questions? Yes. They can only have one baby at once, but actually it starts as two, but only one actually survives, sort of the strongest. Yes. With a bottle. Oh, Matilda, when she was young, he just held her, cradled her, and fed her with a bottle. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Do they kickbox?
Do they kickbox? Well, not professionally, but like I said, I got kicked and they could kickbox. Yeah, what's your question, buddy? You have a question?
Yep. Could I feed him those
two
other
things? Could you feed him that? I'm gonna see, if he doesn't like that sweet potato, then he's probably not gonna go for that, because sweet potato is his favorite. Okay, yes.